I'm loving that bass line already.
Hey, I'm Music by Lucas, and welcome to Baltimore, where we are currently visiting because we travel full time. And today, I'm going to be checking your demos with Lucas and Steve.
Hey, man, what's up?
Yo.
And we might just be choosing some to support, so make sure to stay to the end and subscribe for more videos like this, career tips and tutorials. Hey, what's going on, man? How you doing?
What's up, man?
Yeah, it was Lavecki.
It's got some really cool bell kind of sounds, which is really cool, really fresh, and it doesn't sound like the average preset that everybody knows, which is nice because that's what we see a lot when checking out demos. I really love the side melodies in the drop and also in the break already. It's kind of voices kind of stuff. That's a really nice touch.
Yeah.
I do think that for the drop, I am missing a little bit of energy here. I think the lead sound can also be mixed a little bit apart from the rest. So it will have a little bit more body and aggressiveness, because I'm pretty sure it's meant as a club track, and then, you know, you can have a mistaking in what melody they should follow. So it should be super clear, it should be big, and I'm missing that a little bit.
I do like the edits, like the small kind of edits that you hear in the drop, that makes it really also in the break, kind of that stop, that is pretty cool. Makes it just a little bit unfollowable, if you know what I mean. It is cool because it makes the track a little bit more dynamic. The only thing is that what Lucas already said, I'm missing the festival energy that has to do with the mix of the track. Mix-wise, it's not there. It sounds a bit muddy, which is not bad if you have enough of the sub and of the kick that you feel. But now I think that the kick is falling just a little bit in the background of the track, and kicks and basses in a club track are the most important part of your track and the foundation of the club of the club track. And so a little bit of the muddiness away. I think it's around 200 till 500 hertz, and make a shift upwards the sub. Maybe turn on your kick a little bit louder. That will do the trick already. But overall, I think it is more special than the other demos that we always receive.
It's kind of funny. It kind of sounds like you guys a little bit. Like, I thought the demo kind of had a little bit of a Lucas and Steve vibe.
Yeah. It could be us, like what we did, more of the future house kind of stuff, which we still really like. Don't get me wrong. It's already done. Like, the future house kind of stuff is already there. Yeah. But there are some sounds that can really take this track to next level. So pick out those sounds and then just build it around that.
I think if it's mixed in the right way, it's something that we could definitely play during a set.
He's on the right track.
Maybe a little bit of mixing, a little bit more originality, a little bit more power, a little bit more fullness on the drop, and I think you got it.
Yeah, that's it.
It's a really good one.
Nice.
Sample reminds us, only remind us. It's the same sample that we used in Anywhere, Where Have You Gone. We've got, let me think about you. And then picked up. Sorry you had to hear that, but I felt like I had to explain a little bit.
My voice would be worse, so don't even worry about it.
I mean, it's really cool. I'm sure it will definitely work as a club track. It does remind me a little bit of Bass Jackers, and energy-wise, in the good way. There's only one good way.
Exactly.
I think the melody could be a little bit more catchy. It's an energetic melody. The rhythm is great. It will definitely work. But I think for a big festival anthem, I would prefer a melody that, you know, really takes you away big time. And that's, I mean, it's definitely not bad, but I see some room for improvement there.
Yeah. Same. Arrangement wise, some small things which can be a little bit better, especially in the break. Like, you don't feel when the buildup is coming.
Yeah.
Like, it's there. That's something that I would change, especially for a club track like these. It's important to let people know when the build is coming, when the drop is coming. This build-up came a little bit out of nowhere, which actually didn't bother me that much. But if you're looking for some improvement points, then definitely would look at the break and part of building up a track.
Yeah, it's a really good point.
Which can be a little bit longer, especially if you play this as a festival. It's not nice to have like a just a really small build-up, because you're building kind of a tension in a set. Build-up of that tension is a really, really important part. So I would definitely take the chance to just create a bit, little bit of a longer build-up. It's just a little bit more playable for other DJs.
Yeah, give the audience some time to get their hands up in the air.
Yeah,
if it's only there, they'll be too late. You don't want
the time is too short even to grab your mic and say 3, 2, 1. So
that's it.
I would definitely take some work in the breaks and the build-up.
Mm-hmm.
Definitely agree with Lucas about the melody. It can be catchier. It's not bad. Don't get me wrong. There's nothing bad on this demo. It's really good.
You guys are killing it with the detailed feedback. I'm on your page with this one as well. I think, you know, you're taking the listener on a journey. It's important that you link all the different sections of the track together and build that tension. Take advantage of the, you know, the time and really like take them to the drop in a way that they feel like they're part of it. And then also I just want to say again, with originality, you know, if you send this to an A&R, they might be thinking, this sounds like Lucas and Steve track, this sounds like Bass Jacker's energy, this sound, but does it sound like you? That's the really big thing, is it has to have that edge
of
you.
That's a really good one, what you're saying right now. Yeah.
I think this definitely has an edge that I wouldn't be able to, you know, fit to anybody in particular. Of course, I can think of some names, but it's...
Yeah,
I think
unique.
This is quite...
It is different.
Quite a style on its own. I mean, the style thing is good. I'm not sure whether it's super catchy. Is it original?
I agree.
I think it's very, very original. I do miss a little bit of the catchiness. You can do a little bit more with the chords in the breakdown or the bass or whatever.
It kind of reminds me of what Steve said in the last one about how it's kind of like with the arrangement, like it kind of comes out of nowhere. Like the drop, it's almost hard to follow. Like it's really dope. It sounds great. It's like you said, it's original. It's gritty. It's interesting. But it's almost like the melody or the idea after the buildup, to me, I start to go, like, okay, well, this is cool, but I don't know if I 100% if it gets stuck in my head, you know what I mean?
It
is special. It sounds different than what we earlier listened to. I heard some things mixing wise which is not really nice. It's like the heads and the overheads are in phase, kind of in phase, or they are really, really broad, which is almost gaining to that in phase, which is not really, really nice if you listen to it on mono, then everything falls apart, falls away. Definitely have a look at that. Don't try to put everything as much as stereo as possible. Like every instrument, everything that you use in drops, in breaks, in buildups has to get their own space. If you want to let it breathe or something, like give it their own thing. Some of the overheads and especially the percussion are that broad that you cannot listen to it if you listen to it on PA or big stereo systems. Have a look at that, because that is really important.
Really good technical feedback. I don't think you'd get that from any other people, but you guys play a lot of big shows, so you got a lot of experience hearing it on all the systems.
A lot of people don't know what like phasing is. I would go check out Google first what phasing is, because it is kind of difficult.
Yeah.
But if you understand what it is, then it's really nice to hear. Well, it's not nice to hear, but then it's, you just then you know what you're doing.
And also one last thing, there's also, if you're gonna invest in some studio equipment and you kind of have everything, well, a lot of stuff that you want, there's also equipment with mono switches, which helps a lot
to show you the difference
and to listen on how all your channels, your tracks, and your song are spread.
That's what it's home. James Ireland told me.
I think James Ireland is somebody who's incredibly talented. I'm hearing some really, really cool stuff. Mixing wise, there are some steps to be taken, especially when it comes to the vocal. There's a lot of frequencies that pop out too much. Probably also the recording of it, or I'm not sure if it's a sample or anything, but if you mix that well, you will improve the track big time. Sometimes, you know, in the intro, there's this plug coming in that I and Steve, we would mix it differently. It's a little bit too much, but somehow it does have a super nice edge. Yeah. I mean, the sound comes across. It's a little bit on the line or a little bit over the line of how you should do it, but it is edgy. Cool. Yeah. It's super cool. Yeah. So it does have some good sides on that aspect also. When it comes to the break, there's this piano that I think is a little bit too thin. You can definitely make that so much warmer by EQing it, mixing it the right way, but I think there's also some warmer, more interesting synth sounds, like warm ones, not like the really harsh ones, but you know, just to put on the background to give it more body. I mean, the chords are awesome. It's definitely not that. I think the chords will be even better if you use the right warm sound for that.
Totally agree. Give a little bit of the edge what you had in the plugs to the piano, and then you have a quite a bigger sound. The drop is really clean, like only the bass, the kick, and like the vocal chop, and then the piano comes in, and that just don't give me that right going on feeling, that's what I miss. I do like the demo. I would mix it just in the right way, especially the vocal and the kick bass relation is not really in control or something. It's the kick has too much punch for the bass. I would take off a little bit of the punch of the kick, which is around 100 till probably 200.
Like you're saying, when you have a song like this where it's more minimal, where like you get to the drop and it's more just like a kick, a piano, like more simple.
It has to pop out. Everything has to be
right. Because people's ears are more noticing, they notice more every little detail of those specific sounds. Because some drops, when it's like drop gun, there's so much going on that it's like, you know, it's you're just like swept up in it. But with this kind of thing, it really does have to pop out.
If you mix this track really, really good, then you have something really special. I think it's really cool, something energetic. I do like the track. It's a little bit heavy, compressed, and really, really heavy. Some of these tracks, it works really well. But now I think it's just a little bit over the top, especially if you talk to mixing and mastering. There is no sub, just a little bit lack of really like the low end part, like the subby part that gives your track that warmth and like, holy shit, what is going on here? If you get that back, and that has to come with also with that heavy compression, because you can compress and have it that loud as it is right now, like that flatliner, what it is right now, there can be that much sub, because the first thing that it's getting over compressed and over limited and overdrived is your sub. Right. Maybe just limiting less and compression less on that master, and just pushing that sub back, just find out that balance between heavy compression and bass and sub, and then you're probably good to go. I really like this demo. It's something special, and I do like the vibe, especially the intro is promising.
The intro is really cool. Right away you're like, whoa,
it's really cool.
This?
And I think that is something, if you listen to an intro and it is something promising, then you definitely want to listen to it. And I think he's not disappointing with the drop. I only think that the mixing part on the really low end of the track can be way immenser and massive, because that is in bass house. The genre itself says it already. It's bass house.
Right. Emphasis on bass.
I have the same feeling with this track. If you hear the intro and then the break, it's super epic. It's cool. It's fresh. It's got a lot of new sounds you don't hear in each and every track. So that's a huge plus. I'm really feeling the vocal also in the break.
Yeah,
it's really cool. How he did the formant automation. That's cool. Definitely keep that, especially when it comes to a club track. Those are effects that, you know, just make it sound edgy. That's super sick. But then it comes to the drop, which is nice. Definitely not. Right. It's cool. Right. But yeah, with such an intro, with such a break, I would have expected to be blown out of my chair big time. And yeah, it could have been a little bit more. Sound design in the break and in the intro is crazy. But then in the drop, it's just not as mind-blowing as it is in the beginning. Maybe try to, you know, get some more of those sounds, a little bit more of the vibe from the intro. It sounds crazy to do that for a drop. Yeah. But those were kind of really the sounds that are really making the record.
I agree with Lucas. Lucas agrees with Lucas.
Yes, yeah, we're made for
we're now Lucas and Steve and Lucas. No, yes, Lucas and Steve.
It's not confusing at all.
Not at all. Yeah, I agree 100% about the drop. And I think you're right about tying in sounds from the break and the build-up, because you already like those sounds. You already recognize those sounds.
Yeah.
You're already interested in those sounds. So why not bring them in? Obviously, you can tell there's a lot of talent here.
Yeah,
and I'm really excited to see.
It is a really good one. Everything that we say right now is not that it's bad. Don't take the feedback that you have. It's like, oh my God, they think it's bad, or it's just something that we would do differently.
Yeah.
And take that as an advice. And if you thought that bass or that sub in the last track in Feel It was meant to be like he did it on purpose, then it's fine.
Yeah.
It's just what we think.
Really good point.
Improved.
Because these are all really good demos, just to say. Like,
it is.
The ones we've heard so far are really, really great.
It's a high level, absolutely, high level, without a question.
F-Sauto.
I think we're all feeling the potential in this track.
Yeah.
The feel is there. I think the vocal in the breakdown is super cool. It's definitely
something special.
It's having an edge. It could definitely, you know, be this next pop house radio hit vocal. But in order for it to be that, there are definitely some mixing things that should be addressed. You know, when I listened to the breakdown, I was like, come on, give me that fucking Reezer, put it louder, you know, get it in a mix time and put it loud, put it up, because that's what's, you know, gotta give you that feeling in the break already, then build it up. And in the drop, it's actually pretty minimalistic when he's just adding a head every time, but it works.
It's really cool. However, I feel like it just needs to be developed a bit more, like the foundation is there. I mean, like, when you get to the drop, the melody could be a little bit more intricate on certain parts. It kind of like loops too much, like it could come alive more. It could have more automation with the cutoff. Like, it could kind of be maybe even more trancey. I mean, there's all kinds of opportunities for this one, I think. It's really nice.
Mess a little bit with the chords in the drop.
Yeah.
Why not make it boo, 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 like adding some extra steps. I think that could also, you know, take it to a next level and make that a little bit more interesting.
Yeah, really do like the vibe in this one.
Definitely.
It has that kind of euphoric feeling. Makes me want to listen to it again.
Yeah.
That's something that is really cool. As Lucas said, the vocal is cool. It's really something different. There are some small things that probably could be done a little bit better, especially like the clicks and the smacks in the voice. It's really noticeable. That's something that we always do is before we process a vocal, is just get rid of those smacks of your vocal, because it cleans everything up. That way it is easier to process your vocal. And maybe try some nice reverbs on a send to make the ambience of the vocal a little bit broader than the vocal is.
Yeah.
So the reverb is around that vocal, like stereo-wise, like an ambience kind of thing. You can do that with reverb, you can do that with delay. The vocal doesn't get back in the track, but still is in front. But the verbs are away. That is something that is really cool, because the vibe is there. It is an empty break, so use that space.
And maybe try to also create some extra space by cutting a little bit in the EQ of the chords. There could definitely be made a lot of space there for the vocal. And I think if you do that, vocal will be more upfront. You know,
absolutely.
You will need less of the presence of the vocal. That's a little bit much already, so you can easily cut in there also, because there are simply more space.
Make sure to comment your favorite track and like this video if you like Lucas and Steve. Subscribe here and to Lucas and Steve, become an official member of my team to start working together with me. And now you have to choose which of these videos you want to watch next. That's right.
after this, 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 after this,